Ranto katai la kapana kota sambre ambrota tia kola pahatela. I see an evil in my generation. I see an evil. My generation is settling for nonsense. So because somebody fell under power, you have now arrived as man of God. You don't know anything. After 33 years of ministry, Paul said that I may know you. And the power of your resurrection, 33 years of ministry. This is a man that have seen signs and wonders and miracles. And you just laid hands on somebody, he fell under power. And they have not called you pastor and you are angry. That's why you will never amount to anything in the kingdom. Go and hide yourself. Nobody is interested in knowing you. We are only interested in knowing people that have known God, being with him long enough in the spirit, and the hand of God comes on them and they become witnesses to our generation. The certain kind of man that God seeks. The truth is that we are not saying you are not somebody. We are saying that the man that God is looking for, you are not yet that man. That is why the rulership of darkness and Satan is still persisting in your territory, in your city. Are you getting the point now? There is a certain kind of man, a witness to that territory that God is looking for. And that is the basis of what we are crying for. You are in an office and everybody is collecting bribe. And you are collecting. When you finish, you come and pay tithe. Sorry. You are not. You even speak in tongues. Oh God, bless me. Satan will. You know what Satan will do? We allow you to have more money so that you will walk in that path thinking it's blessing for long, and then you will be ensnared that bribery and corruption is a blessing. You don't know revival. In the days of Charles Finney, they shut down all the places they sell alcohol, and you are still asking, is the alcohol a sin? For 100 years they didn't sell. In the days of Evan Roberts, people got so soaked in God that the animals that they used to call foul names, they can't call the name, and the animals can't respond to them again. And you think falling under power, this one is revival. What has it changed? How many territories have you held down for God? But there is an evil I'm seeing in my generation. They are settling for nothing. What somebody wants from this meeting now is to move from here, and maybe what you see one man of God here do, and you go and do it, possibly it will work for you. And you say, we have arrived. I fasted for 300 days and then this thing began to, you have not paid the price. When you pay the price. No, Jesus has paid the price. This one we are doing is not any price. No, the scripture says, for the love of God constraineth us. What we are doing is based on love. If I don't walk in anointing, I will still fast and pray. It is a commandment. The scripture says, when you fast, it did not say if you fast. And when he's saying it, he was not talking about anointing and power. Give me strength. Let me fly. He was not talking about anointing and power. He said, when you give, he said, when you pray, men pray because it's a commandment. If God needs my prayer, I will continue praying.